Hi, I'm Ryan Voss, and you're watching Tribe TV.
Hey, Ash, what are you doing?
Well, now that the weather is so nice, I just want to be outside all the time.
So do so many of our classmates. Let's catch up on how they feel about their senioritis.
Gabrielle Keith, and I'm a senior.
Mike Frasinoni, and I'm a senior at LC. The definition of senioritis is not coming to school or showing up late or trying to leave and get out of here as quick as you can.
Pretty much covered it. senior year. Probably like around now, like the end of the year, when it gets hot out.
Cure to senioritis is good grades, because that means you really don't have to come to school if you have good grades.
Probably like going to college, because you kind of have to come to school if you want good grades.
There's no advice, you're stuck. It's happening. It's happening.
Senioritis is absolutely real.
My name's Rebecca Todd, I'm a senior. Senioritis to me is just like pretty much giving up on like your last year of high school. I'd say I got senioritis like right at the second semester of my senior year. My strategy was to do as much as I could in the beginning, because I knew I wouldn't want to do anything at the end, and I'd say it worked. But yeah, senioritis is alive and well. The cure for senioritis is to graduate. I think it's unavoidable. I think, you know, you're just gonna get it at one point, you're just ready to be done, so yeah.
I'm Nick Schell, and I'm a senior. Senioritis is just missing a lot of days of school and just not slacking off and stuff. Probably the first day of school.
It is.
It definitely is a real disease. There is no cure. There really isn't. Just stay focused, and that's really it.
I'm Stefan Vukovic. I'm a senior.
I'm Aaron Schasberger. I'm also a senior. Losing all motivation to do anything school-related.
Wanting to get out of school, getting out of school, dropping out of high school.
Yeah. Hi, I'm Cole Geiser. I'm a senior here. My definition of senioritis would be, after you get accepted into the school you want to get into, all or any motivation you have for a Lake Central just disappears completely. I got senioritis probably when I walked in here my senior year. I leave school at 12:30 every day. My attendance record is more than stellar. It is a horrible disease. I'm self-diagnosed. I want to diagnose others about it and spread word about it. Cure for senioritis is definitely graduating and just leaving. There isn't a way to not get it.
Paige, why are you wearing a sombrero?
Well, I actually won life of the party at senior banquet. Let's see what award everyone else got. So really, we're just here for a good time.
I would just have to say it's embedded in my skull. Paying attention for 20 minutes every class makes me a teacher's pet, then I'm a dog.
This is my normal voice. I literally like catch myself screaming sometimes.
I don't. Like, people tell me to quiet down and I'm just like...
I'm not even sarcastic, so I really don't even know why I got this award.
I have people fooled.
Golf.
Baseball.
Softball.
Basketball.
Basketball.
Football.
Elite roller skating.
Soccer.
Soccer.
Track.
Powder puff football.
So I'm really involved in our special ed program here, and that's one of the main reasons why I'm going to Ball State to become a teacher.
They call us Ranch.
Cause we be dressing.
I don't know how to behave.
Yeah, me neither.
Yeah.
I used to be ugly. Like,
that just happened.
God bless America.
Spread love and kindness.
Have you seen this thing?
My ex wants my baby.
Did you study for that test tomorrow?
What test?
I've recently been working with a bunch of celebrities through Locka Films and Lyrical Lemonade, and they kind of became like normal people to me.
Basically, we've been best friends since sixth grade, all through middle school.
remained best friends all throughout high school.
And we spent the next four years together as roommates at IU Bloomington now.
Josh and stuff, that's like my personal brand.
Brittany Howell with 3 L's.
We are!
L.C. Hey, why'd the chicken cross the road?
Absolutely.
Turn signals, mirrors, parking. No. Just no.
Yeah, left turns really aren't my thing either.
We dated in like 8th grade and then all of freshman year.
We broke up a couple times, but
yeah.
We remained friends through it all. And now we're best friends and we're seniors in high school going off to college together.
Now that high school is coming to an end, let's check out some tips for high school from some graduating seniors.
Hi, I'm Tommy Pritchett. I'm a senior. My 3 tips for successful high school is making sure you get your work done and knowing what you need to do to be successful. And make sure you want to take fun classes, or you want to take, you know, some classes in between the days so that you're, you know, not doing all work, you're having fun at the same time, so you're not being intimidated by all the strong classes. And third is make sure you have fun in high school. You don't want to be too stressed.
Hi, I'm Michael Bender and I'm a senior at Lake Central High School, and these are my 3 tips of success. My first tip to success is hygiene. You have to look good, let's be honest. No one wants to look at yellow teeth when you walk around in the hallways. My second tip is you want to be social. You want to make as many friends as possible because you want as many weekend plans as possible. My third tip is you can't procrastinate, because if you procrastinate on a project, you're going to be up till 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning. I've experienced this before, and you just don't want to be half asleep in high school.
I'm Katie Fiorio, I'm a senior, and my 3 tips for success in high school are to do all your homework and turn all of it in. Do not have any PDA in the hallway because it's gross. And just don't walk slow or stand in the middle of the hallway because it's annoying.
What's up, Lake Central? I'm Colin Tomaszewski, and this is the next segment. We have some seniors talking about their freshman selves and some advice they would give to their freshman selves. So let's go check it out.
Hi, I'm Taylor Chandler and I'm a senior. So freshman year, I was really quiet and I didn't talk to anyone. And then as I got older, I started making more friends and like talking more. And now my senior year, I talk all the time and I have a lot of friends that I wish I would have met my freshman year. So some advice I would give my freshman self was to step out of my comfort zone sooner, because I made a lot of friends now that I didn't have my freshman year that I wish I would have met.
Hey, what's up? I'm Nick Rivera. I'm a senior and I participated in band throughout most of high school. I probably would have tried to dedicate myself more. I probably would have tried to put in more effort to kind of focus on helping myself more than the other people around me. I learned what hard work was and discipline through that program. And I don't know, it just taught me a lot of things that I can use later in life.
Hi, I'm Tanner Hoffman, I'm a senior. Since my freshman year, I've matured a lot and I've met a lot of people through like baseball and stuff. Just enjoy high school while it lasts, especially like for sports and stuff, because it might be the last time you play with your friends.
Hi, I'm Joel Rivera, I'm a senior. Some advice I give my past self freshman year, I'd say just like relax a bit, and like you can do your work, but don't try so hard to, as in you're like stressing yourself out, it's not really worth it. Like just chill out with friends, like just have fun. Because it's like, it's the only 4 years you're going to get in high school, so I'd say just relax. I changed by, like, when I came in, I came from, like, a private school. I didn't know many people, but now I know a lot of people, I have a lot of friends, do a lot of stuff, and, like, I generally just opened up a lot more. Like, even though my grades are, like, still the same, like, I learned to balance everything out, and learn to do some fun stuff and have a good time and just enjoy myself.
Hi, I'm Matthew Florida, and let's catch in with some seniors to view their favorite high school memories.
Hi, I'm Michael Bandura. I'm a senior, and my favorite high school memory was when Nick Anderson hit the buzzer beater in the Monster Lake Central 7th game.
Okay, hi, my name is Morgan. I'm a senior, and my favorite high school memory is going to Disney and
competing with my cheer team.
Hi, my name is Haley Benko. I'm a senior, and my favorite memory was one day at dance, one of the girls was doing a magic trick where you just do this, and one of the girls thought it was so funny.
My name is Madison Frederick, and my favorite memory is probably when Ms. Zentz did her day where she breaks social norms, and it freaks everyone out, and it's really funny to watch.
Let's take a look at some teacher's advice for our senior graduates.
My name is Mr. Holden. I teach AP Psychology here at Lake Central High School. Little message to seniors. Seniors, when you walk out the doors that last day of school, the first time you come back in through those doors is going to be a little different, okay? First 4 years of high school goes very fast. College is going to go even faster. Enjoy the next 4 to 6 or 8 years, however long you're going to be getting your degrees. Don't forget where you came from. I always give back to community, stay in touch with friends, teachers, what have you, and just do the best you can do and go for your dreams. Go for your dreams.
I was saying earlier today, I do actually like this senior class, the year 2018. I have a lot of students that I'm going to miss. I know a lot of them are going to be going on to bigger and better things. We always say this, it seems so cliche. Every year we get interviewed and we have like little bits of knowledge and nuggets to pass along. But people who are going out there, just be successful in life, take chances, and go for it, man. Don't be afraid. Don't be timid. Be a little aggressive and go for what you want.
I'm Ms. Medicki. I teach publications and photography and journalism here. And my advice to the seniors is to study hard. Even if you're not going to college, work hard. Always try your best. Be kind to others, and you know, take advantage of the opportunities that are in front of you while you're young. Before you settle down, get a career, have a family, go travel, see the world, and do all those adventures that you know always dreamed of before. Get into the real world. You've got time for that.
I'm Lauren Small, and I'm going to IU Northwest.
I'm Lauren Lewowski, and I'm going to University of Illinois Springfield.
My name is Jackson Long, and I'm going to play football at the University of St. Francis in Fort Wayne.
Hi, I'm Brian Kelly. I'm going to Hillsdale College in Hillsdale, Michigan, to play football.
I'm Alexis Mostowski, and I'm playing golf at IU Bloomington.
I'm Hunter Zaborski, and I'm going to South Suburban College.
I'm Connor Thomason, and I'm going to Purdue West Lafayette.
I'm Ray Hilbert.
I'm Connor Hoffman.
I'm Justin Graves, and we're going to PNW.
I'm Stannis Spears, and I'm going to IU Bloomington.
I'm Noah Sarin, and I'm going to IU PUI.
I'm Riley Kutsusik, and I'm going to Purdue West Lafayette.
I'm Jessica Kiefer, and I'm going to Ball State.
I'm Madison Tucker, and I'm going to St. Francis.
I'm Alexa Panarski, and I'm going to Columbia University.
I'm Amanda Noblet.
I'm Selena Michiko, and we're going to Purdue Northwest.
I'm Noah Cullen, going to Trine University.
I'm Kyra Marshall, going to Indiana Tech University.